At the Collaborative Research Centre Prominence in Language in Cologne, language is thought of in many ways.
What is prominence in language? Think of communication. You get a lot of information, get a flood of information, and to highlight certain units, to make those units more prominent, helps the hearer to get easy access to the most important information. I think kicker is a wonderful metaphor for language. The goal of a kicker play is that two people play together. Yeah, they have to be very fast because they have to play against opponents. And they have to show to each other what the next move will be. And so they have to make the position prominent where the ball is going. The ball is the theme of our conversation. And each communication, each dialogue has also a goal. So the ball plays basically the way through our dialogue up to the end. We assume that languages have a prominent structure, but how we use prominence in a particular language by a particular speaker might be different. So if, for example, if you want to highlight a word, you can accent the word, you can make it louder, but you can also speak the word much longer. So the way you do this might be different, and the very fascinating thing is that independent how you do it, the hearer will always recognize that this word is the most prominent word in that sentence.
Currently, the CRC prominence in language has three different areas. One area that looks at prominence in phonology, the other area looks at prominence in morphosyntax, and the third area looks at prominence in discourse. So in each of these areas, we have 5 to 7 different projects contributing to the research questions of prominence in language.
With the expertise of more than 70 scientists, we create a new understanding of language as a system between cognition and communication.
The advantage of the research in the CRC prominence in language is that we have different labs and different methods that can all contribute to the overall research question of prominence.
Hat er die Bürste auf die Bohme gelegt?
Er hat die Bürste auf die Mahne gelegt.
In addition to that, we have a number of researchers who work on languages such as in Mexico or in Papua New Guinea. And so this is beneficial for us because we assume that prominence is a general principle.
One key element of our research center is the promotion of the next generation of researchers.
Being a PhD student within the CRC is a great advantage because you have a group of PhD students who all work on prominence in language, and they meet on a regular basis as part of the ARTIS graduate program. And so this is a thriving environment for them to exchange their ideas and communicate with each other.
We have colleagues from different fields. We have colleagues from prosody, we have colleagues from typology, and we have colleagues from semantic pragmatics and discourse studies. And having brought all these people together is why this is very special and why we don't find a comparable research project elsewhere, not in Germany and not internationally.